Welcome to Constraint-Based Data Collection for Evaluating Model Robustness. A longer version of this abstract will appear in EMNLP 2020. The title is a little bit longer, and that's displayed at the bottom. The objective here is to answer some questions about generalizability and model robustness. First, how can we tell if an intent classification or slot filling model is robust? Can the model generalize, and is the dataset diverse enough to provide for generalizability? The way we try to answer that is by crowdsourcing new test sets of existing datasets using a new approach where we iteratively constrain the words that crowd workers can use. We grow what are called taboo lists for each intent or slot, and candidate taboo words are mined using an SVM or a CRF. What that looks like is typically for data collection, crowd workers look at a sentence and they'll paraphrase it. That's how we generate data. What we're doing here, though, is we're looking at the data that's been generated. We're mining which tokens are indicative of certain intents or slots, and then we're adding those to a taboo list so that crowd workers can't use them in the future. So in this case, the words from and to are probably highly indicative of airport slots, and the CRF would learn that, and we tell the worker not to use from or to in the future. So in the future, they might say out of and into as replacements for from and to, and that's what's generating diversity and variety of language. So a model will be robust if it can handle these different variations. To evaluate, we collected new test sets for existing intent classification and slot filling data sets. We collected data sets using 0, 2, 4, and 6 taboo words. What we found for intent classification is that performance takes a quite substantial drop going from 0 to only 2 taboo words. In most cases, except for the SNPs dataset. For slot filling, the results were quite similar. A little bit less drastic, but still quite severe in several cases. What this is saying is a lot of these datasets don't really provide the ability to train models that can generalize to these new ways of saying quite simple phrases. And that's a problem with these data sets.